How's it going, everyone? MonkeyDoo22 here, and I'm going to be helping Scratch with this video by providing the console footage and steps from the console streamer's perspective.
Thanks, Monkey Dude, for the assist here getting footage so we can show the newest update coming to the Xbox One. What's up, everybody? This is Scratch, and we're going to take a look at controller sharing on the Mixer app and a really cool feature update coming for console streamers. At the time of this filming, this is in the alpha wave of the Xbox Insider program, but fear not, it'll be rolling out to the new waves and then eventually to the public in the future. Unless, of course, this video is really old and that's already happened. Looking at MonkeyDude22's perspective, you can see the new options when you're starting up a stream, and there is an option now to share your controller. Toggle that switch and viewers will see an option show up in the interactive area of the Mixer stream. On a first-come, first-served basis, viewers can then scramble to be the one to take control of the game, at which point a digital controller will spawn in the interactive area with the available buttons for control. Only one viewer at a time has control of the shared controller, and there are indicators that show who took control. And of course, the host has options to remove them and open it back up or turn it off completely. On the digital controller, you'll notice that there isn't an Xbox button. You wouldn't want people to log into your profile, changing things and restarting your Xbox or whatever. However, that doesn't mean that they couldn't go into a menu and delete a save game or cause you a problem, so just be aware of that before giving control permissions. If the viewer doesn't like the digital controller, they can plug in an Xbox-compatible controller into their PC via USB cable and use that to control the game along with the host as well. You don't need to do anything but plug it into the PC you'll be watching the stream from and just go for it. You do share the controller with the host, and it's similar to the co-pilot mode for Xbox One. Swapping between the viewer controller, the digital controller, and the streamer is as easy as just pressing the controller you want to use. It's essentially three controllers connected to the same input. And yes, if you're wondering, it does technically work on mobile. However, due to the lag associated with mobile networks, screen size versus finger size, it's not very useful, although you could technically accomplish it to some degree. If that wasn't enough, console streamers can now switch games in the middle of their streams without going offline, which keeps their audience in the stream, and the game will update once you load back in. Multi-game streams are now possible on the console, and this is really going to help those who marathon stream for things like Extra Life. Monkey Dude and I played with Maxon and Four Ninja Toads for a bit to check this out, and we found that it worked pretty decent for games like Manual Samuel, and I think it would work amazingly well with the Telltale series of games. There are many opportunities to come up with creative ways for people to interact with your streams, although if you're looking for someone to grab you those hard achievements in, say, Battletoads and Rare Replay, you're going to have to find a real ringer to pull that off. I personally would love to see someone give PUBG or Fortnite Hype Zone the controller to see if they can finish out the game and bring home the win. Anyways, thanks for watching, and if you have any comments, please leave them down below. I'm super curious to see what you guys think about this, or to see what interactive ways you're going to come up with when this is available to you, or if it is available to you and you're using it already. Let us know what you're doing. We're curious to know, and I think it's going to make for some pretty interesting Mixer streams in the near future. Monkey Dude is going to be doing a Q&A follow-up session on his channel, so make sure to leave a comment down below for that, and then check the cards in the end screen for his channel. And of course, there is a link to his channel down in the description of nearly all of my recent videos over the last few months, because Monkey Dude is a supporter of this channel and sponsors me to do this. So thank you for that, and you guys go down and check him out. Any video you're watching, you'll find a link to his channel down in the description. So thanks for watching, and I will catch you guys all later.